everybody. We made it. Another week of college basketball is around the corner. I'm going to decide to stick with it with the whole, you know, weekly recap and weekly, you know, preview stuff like that. So here we go. Here we go. It is going to be a good week, let me tell you that. And it's mostly because the Big Ten has 9 teams ranked in the top 25 right now. They have 9 teams ranked in the top 25. Crazy stuff. And Minnesota has 3 ranked matchups this week. First off, it gets Michigan State. That's tonight, Thursday night. Thursday night, they have... I'm going down here. Wait, that's Saturday. Oops. Thursday night, they have Wisconsin. And then Sunday, they have Ohio State. Crazy stuff right there. Crazy stuff. And, I mean, the rest of the Big Ten is no slouch. I mean, we've talked about these teams, you know, several times before. But I also want to talk about little old Missouri. They are undefeated. They are ranked number 12 in the nation right now. Jeremiah Tillman and all those guys out there in Missouri are having a great season so far. They're getting ready for SEC play. And they have to take on Yves Pons and Tennessee, and also Arkansas on Saturday. So that is going to be interesting there. I will definitely try and check out the Missouri game on Saturday. I don't know about Wednesday, though. I don't know if I'm feeling it for Wednesday. But, yeah, I think there's a bowl game that day, so I don't think I'll be able to watch that game. But Saturday, definitely I'll check out Missouri and see what they're all about. And Tennessee, also very highly ranked. I think they're still undefeated, too. Very highly ranked. As far as the rest of the contenders go and stuff like that, and the rest of the teams in the country, most teams are still, you know, either starting conference play already or have a couple of non-conference games left, or maybe just one. That, like in the case of Gonzaga, they're taking on Dixie State on Tuesday night, and then they start West Coast Conference play against the team that beat Virginia, San Francisco. And Virginia, they have some big-time matchups as well. I don't know about Virginia Tech, you know, because they have them this week. I think it's on Sunday or Saturday or something like that, that they have Virginia Tech. And, you know, Virginia's got to bounce back this week. They got Notre Dame on Wednesday, and it's going to be a problem, I think. You know, Notre Dame is scrappy and tough, but Virginia just has to get it together. They have to get over the hangover. What about Iowa? What about Luka Garza and company? They got to get some defense out there, and a big-time test for the Hawkeyes against Northwestern. Going to be crazy. Houston this week, they take on Tulsa, and I'm not sure who else they play this week. Let me go down to maybe Saturday or Sunday. Yeah, they play Tulsa and SMU this week. So, yeah, there's also another big matchup for Northwestern taking on Michigan. And Michigan is a team I honestly have not seen play yet. I don't know why I haven't seen them play yet. I mean, the way things have been working out is I haven't been able to see this team play yet. So, I'll talk about Michigan soon enough when I finally get a chance to see them play. It's a game. Oregon's back in the top 25 as well. They got a game against Stanford on Saturday. Big time Saturday, especially, you know, during the rest of these bowl games and stuff like that in college football, which we'll talk about in a few moments, or rather, probably tomorrow, to talk about these New Year's Six bowl games. But yeah, my Longhorns are number 8 in the country. I don't know how, I don't know why, but we're taking on Kansas on Saturday. There's also Iowa-Rutgers on Saturday. Big time matchup there. Yeah, again, the Virginia-Virginia Tech matchup, you know, that is also there. The Duke still somehow ranked in the top 20. They're taking on Florida State. That's at 5, you know, or 6 p.m. if you want to be, you know, want to be like that. And then there's, again, that Gonzaga-San Francisco matchup. Who's going to stop Gonzaga? I don't know yet. I mean, It's just the Big Ten is just going to be a dog fight this year. It's going to be a dog fight. It's going to be crazy. You know, there's a lot of stars all over the place in this conference. And I think it truly is a very deep conference. Truly is. And I know I've been saying this for the past couple of videos that the Big Ten has been very deep as a conference. But, I mean, it's real. It's true. You know, people were saying earlier today that that, you know, hey, we might have a team that's under 500 in the Big Ten go to the Big Dance. And I think that's just, obviously that's a little crazy for mid-majors, but, you know, it just speaks to the depth of the volume of this conference that, you know, it's a damn good conference. Damn good conference out here. There's a lot of ACC teams ranked too, but I think the effect has worn off a little bit. North Carolina, I don't think they're even ranked right now. I think they might still be ranked, but I'm not sure. I know they have a game. I know they had a game that was supposed to be on here, on the little Google thing I have, and I don't see them here. I don't see them at all here. But yeah, tough test all around for most of these teams that are starting conference play, especially in the Power Five, or not the Power Five. I mean the you know, the big conferences, the Big Seven. I call it the Big Seven because the American is a big conference in college basketball, and the Big East, of course. Big East is still, you know, trudging along, even though COVID has taken away probably their best game this weekend, which was Xavier at Villanova. But yeah, the rest of the country is on notice. They're on notice, and they know that the Big Ten is very mighty this year. And again, there's just going to be a lot of chaos in this conference. But there's going to be some fun stuff in these other conferences as well. We can't just say, oh, well, the ACC is going to be not good. They're going to find a way to get 6 or 7 teams in this tournament. The Big 12 is always going to be good. You know, the Pac-12 is a little bit struggling right now, but they can get something put together. SEC, I know it's been, you know, Kentucky's 1-6 now and just not good. But and I know John Calipari was like, oh, well, we shouldn't have assembled the schedule, blah, blah, blah. But hey, that's your own fault. You need to schedule tough if you want to be a big boy. You know, stop whining. But Tennessee, Missouri, it looks like they're going to pick up the slack from Kentucky this year based on how they've been playing. And 2021 is just going to be great for college basketball. You know, that whole stretch from January all the way to the beginning of April, going to be the funnest time of the year. You know, now that the NFL is winding down, now college football is pretty much over, everything is winding down, and now basketball will be my main focus here. So, with that being said, everybody, I'll see you guys in the next video, which will be probably later tonight to talk the NFL and how Week 16 shook up. Y'all take care.